strongly endorse this amendment put forward by Deputy Stanley. Monoculture or overdependence on one or two sectors is a very dangerous game, I think. And we need to diversify. We need to diversify enterprise and industry generally in this country, and we certainly need to diversify agriculture. And the idea that we will just have an ever onwards and upwards beef export industry, or we can just solely rely on beef and dairy, is a mistake. It makes us very vulnerable to any sort of serious fluctuations, increased competition, disease, all sorts of things that could potentially hit a single sector. And therefore make the entire economy vulnerable. We learned the folly of over-concentration on a particular sector with the property crash, and it would be devastating if we learned the same in the areas of agriculture that, if you like, we have prioritised and focused on. So they're very important sectors, but you have to have diversity basically for safety, apart from anything else, for the sustainability and protection of the economy heading into the future. And I don't know as much as Deputy Stanley does about the sugar beet sector and the sugar industry, but it is an amazing fact that even in Dunleary, you have people who regularly approach me and decry the collapse of the sugar industry and say it was a national tragedy that we allowed it to happen. And certainly the passion and conviction with which this point is put, and I think has been echoed by Deputy Stanley in the area, an area of the country where it was very much affected, I think to me proves the point and is an indication of the need to take resurrecting that industry very, very seriously. But I would also add in another crop that I think is important, that we have desperately underperformed on, and a sector that we have allowed to decline. Of course, there was historical reasons why it was devastated under British rule. Is the area of forestry. I won't go into it in great length. It's been discussed at much length during the forestry bill. But it is an absolute tragedy and shame that in the country in Europe, which has the best conditions for growing trees anywhere in Europe, we have the lowest level of forest cover. And this is a perfect crop for addressing climate change, CO2 emissions, dealing with the consequences of climate change and environmental damage. And yet we have really spectacularly failed to develop this sector. And insofar as we have developed, again, we've developed it on a sort of monocultural basis, with one crop really being prioritised with questionable effects, if you like, on the soil, on the water, and again making it vulnerable potentially to disease and so on, when we should be diversifying in that area and expanding in that area to a very significant extent. So I think, those are just two areas that are mentioned here. I think there are lots more, but this focus on crops and diversification in developing industry and enterprise and agriculture that can be beneficial, sustainable environmentally, beneficial in terms of meeting our targets, and just good economically, socially, and in every other way, this has to be a really key part of us moving towards a sustainable future and dealing with the issue of climate change. So I think it's a very reasonable and sensible amendment, Minister, and I see no reason why you wouldn't accept it. And it's very much the direction we need to go to start to think outside the box and widen our horizons, and in some cases just go back to things we used to do And both of these are things we used to do. You know, this was a forest-covered country. And similarly, we had a sugar industry. And both those things have been devastated. But in fact, they're things we could do terribly, terribly well with multiple benefits at every level. So I think you should accept amendment. And most importantly, I think the government and future governments need to take the spirit of the amendment very, very seriously in addressing not just climate change, but a sustainable economic and environmental future.